is a candle in every soul. Some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle and makes his home. So carry your candle.
Even to the moms, the mothers, right? In some countries, in most countries, it is developing. It's a form of antibiotics. Okay? It's a form of an ARV which they get to enable delivery to be very safe for children. Are we okay with it? So why I'm telling you this, I need you to understand a little bit more about HIV. Okay? And AIDS. Okay? Good. Now, if you are HIV positive, you can live positively by making sure that you take care, good care of your body, your mind, and spirit. Okay?
Yes.
Good. You eat the right foods, you get ARVs, and you take them for life, and you take them religiously. In other words, it is called drug adherence. Okay? So with that, you live a healthy life. In some countries, they are always counseling mechanisms to support you live your life. There are support groups which you can go to, right? Is there someone who is lost? I'm giving you the basics on HIV and AIDS, and I don't want you to get lost. So if you have questions, just like my brother there, he asks good questions. Ask a question. When I leave this place, I want you to be a little bit smart on HIV. Huh? You can go home and tell mom and papa that I know a little bit more about HIV. You can go and tell your friends that I know a little bit about. Yes. You're smarter than others out there. If you were staying, most of you are in grade 7. If you were staying here, I would have said, I'm campaigning so that prefects will come from here, because you'll be smarter than their prefects. Right. How is it? Are we okay? All right. Now, there's something that is called stigma and discrimination. Is there anyone who knows what that is? Stigma and discrimination. Normally these words tend to go together. Anyone who has met it before? No. Anyone who has met it before? You want to try? No. Good. What these two words simply mean is that you are looking down upon someone who is HIV positive. You are separating yourself from that person and you don't want to associate yourself with that person. You are removing the dignity of that person. Okay? That is what it means. So if you segregate yourself, if you remove yourself, you no longer want to play with the person, you no longer want to even touch that person, you are discriminating, and that's wrong. You are stigmatizing, and that's wrong. Because anyone who is HIV positive is just like you. They've got a condition which they have and is not communicable. I mean, As long as you don't do those things that we talked about, no blood contact, no sharing of needles, no sharing of razor blades, no sleeping together, having sex together, you can do pretty much everything. You can play football together, you can play netball, you can play tennis. Do you play tennis here?
No.
No. You play netball?
No.
Volleyball? Volleyball? And enjoy, there's nothing wrong. The moment you start running away from those people, you don't want to be associated with them, you look down upon them. Do you know how you look at rubbish, waste, you know, things that you dispose? Now if you start to look at them like that, you're stigmatizing and you're discriminating. And that's wrong. You should be a good Samaritan. Okay? Because that person is just a person just like you. Alright. So I'm giving you the basics on HIV and AIDS. We have touched on how you can get infected, isn't it?
Yes.
Is there anyone with questions there? We have touched on how to prevent, yes? We have got a question, yes?
So, when a person goes to the hospital,
yes,
and he wants to check up if he has HIV positive or negative, then maybe the results come out and he is HIV positive, and the doctor, maybe that the result was forged. Then
the result
is
HIV negative, but was told that it is HIV positive. The doctor gives him or her to get take care of this.
Is it going to infect him or her? When he is HIV negative?
No. It doesn't. You don't get infected when you take ARV. It's a sin. It's when your immune system is down and you get many infections. But the question is it man-made or is natural? Now, the answer, my friend, is the world doesn't know. Okay? The world doesn't know whether it was man-made or it was natural. Now, there are theories. Now, I'm going to give you two theories that are there. The one that has been received a little bit more is that it came from some monkeys. Okay? It came from some monkeys because there's a similar virus called simian virus. Okay? In monkeys. So they think it evolved from there. And then the other theory is that which has been spearheaded by Dr. Oreski and Alan Cantwell from the United States. These two doctors say it was man-made in the United States. So these are the two theories, but the animal one has been received in some circles as, but like what I said, the true origin of the virus is not yet known, just like the cure. Okay. Good. That's a smart question. Any other smart question? Any other smart question? Yes? Speak a little bit louder.
If it was natural or man-made, how did it reach human beings?
All right. Natural or man-made, they all reach human beings in this essence. Flu is natural. You can get it by if you get to, for instance, if you get infected by someone who has it, or by conditions within you, right? Good. I mean, it's just natural. It is there, and then you can get infected either from someone, right? And the thing about viruses is once you get it, it's not curable. I think that I have to share with you. All right, now listen. There are two things that troubles many kinds in terms of diseases. Two. One is called bacteria. And then the other is called
virus.
These are two different things, and they cause diseases. But the trick is, every disease that is caused by bacteria is curable. Okay? So every disease that is caused by bacteria is curable. But every disease that is caused by a virus is not. Right, just like flu. Flu is a virus. So if you get flu, you cannot be cured from it. It can go away when you are fine. But when you get infected, it stays. There's no way to cure it. All right? Good. How it gets to people who get infected? For the man-made, they say it was the homosexuals in the United States were infected first, blah, 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 was the theory. But they're just the theories. In some cases, they don't concern us. And then the other one for the monkeys, they think probably the monkeys, probably someone ate the monkeys or someone was killing the monkeys, and then somehow blood contaminated a human being and then it gets started to transmit in various forms, including sexual, just like, you know, these ones that we talk about. Okay, you still have a question? You can stand up and speak loud. You think, there is a way I'm very far, I want you to shout so that others can hear. It is not curable. The HIV virus is not curable. And it's not because it is spread very quickly. That's not the reason why it is not curable. It is not curable because, do you want to try? You want to answer? Right. It is not curable because the virus mutates. In other words, how many people have seen Mutant X? Not that movie. Do you want to see this?
Which movie?
Mutant X.
X.
Mutant X. Or X-Men.
Ah,
you have watched X-Men?
Yes.
All right, that's nice. Now, on X-Men, there's that lady who takes any shape. What's her name? Yeah? Do you watch X-Men, you people?
Yes.
There's that lady who is always green.
Blue.
She's what?
Yonani.
Right. She can take any form, right?
Yes.
Now, what the virus, hey, now you're talking and I'm talking. What the virus does is that it mutates, it is able to change. It mutates from one point to the other. At the same time, it creates strains, different strains of itself. So because of that, it is not curable.
HIV infected.
So it creates a situation where if it happens that you get HIV infected, the virus might be resistant to the or the line, the ARV line or regimen you are taking. You get that? So the ARVs, they've got what are called regimens. In some countries, they are known as lines. Now, first line, third line. No, these are groups of ARVs that you take. Now, if you, for instance, if you are HIV positive, you take a certain line, you're supposed to take it for life. If you stop for some time and then take it again, the virus may develop resistance. In other words, those drugs won't work on you anymore. You can take them, but still progress to AIDS. So if you take them and they're still HIV negative, they're creating a situation where there's an imbalance. When you get HIV infected, it might also cause some resistance. Okay, but that was a smart question. Say smart people.
Smart people.
I'm liking you. I wish I could stay. Sister, can I get a room? I wish I could stay with these smart people. Smart questions. I love you already. Yes. So we've talked about living positively. And said living positively, what it simply means is, number one, you have decided not to infect other people and you protect other people from infection and protect yourself from infection. Even if you're HIV positive, there's what is called reinfection. Okay? Because HIV has got different strains. You can have a certain strain in you and get infected with another strain, and that can kill you.
I don't want this.
And you are still standing at the same position.
Please don't do that. Please don't touch me. I'm still young.
That is what we wanted you to listen to. And you are busy talking. You don't refuse when you communicate a position. You communicate it verbally and you communicate it non-verbally. Verbally, you say it straight, no, I do not want. And then your body should say the same, okay? Push with your strength and run away. Instead of running away, she manages to get out of his hands. Instead of opening the door and run away, she goes and start calling someone. Why, if you start calling someone there, he will come and get you again. Why can't you open the door and run away? So when you say no to situations, you have to know how to say it. Know how to say no. We are saying this because there are so many girls that have been raped. And also nowadays, because of homosexuals, there are so many guys also that are being abused. So you have to learn to say no, and the right way to say no. She wasn't like it. You make the right decision. Then we said, no, your body, your mind, and spirit. If he had known that what he's doing will affect his body and in turn affect his mind, therefore could not pass and continue with his life, perhaps he would not have taken drugs. Perhaps he would not have taken the alcohol he was now taking. And then the flirting with the girls. Because when your mind is no longer thinking straight, you won't pass. You fail your exams, you fail your education, you won't go anywhere and probably get HIV and pregnant and they're chased away from school. You see what happened there? Is that what you want with your life?
No.
So I'm going to ask you to be quiet just for a moment, just for a minute, and ask yourself, what is it that you want with your life? Some people, they never. Some people have never given themselves a moment to think about where they want to go with their lives. How many people are finishing primary this year? What do you want to do with your life? Have you ever thought about it? Do you have dreams about your life? Do you have desires? These are the goals that smart people set goals. These are the goals that I want to achieve in my life. So let me give you a moment, if you haven't, just to think about what you want with your life. Think about what you want to achieve, where you want to go with your life. Whether you want to make your parents proud, like what he was doing before, or you want to upset your parents and make your parents an object for laughter, and I mean everyone in the society will be laughing at them for having you. What do you want to do with your life? Because whatever you decide, you have to make the right moves from today. So I want you to remember that move from today onwards. Every move you make, ask yourself, is this the right move or the wrong move? If we come back again here, after 5 years, the question we'll ask you is, did you make the right move? Okay. If we come back here after 5 years, if we meet you, we're going to ask you, did you make the right moves? So, as you go out to have your lunch, because from here we'll be going to have our lunch, I want you to find someone. As you have your lunch, talk to someone. Share what you want to do with your life. My friend, myself, I decided I want to be a doctor. This is what I want to do with my life. I know what it takes. It means I have to pass my... what do you need to be a doctor here?
Science.
Science and math, right?
Yes.
Good. Yeah. So I need to pass my science and math, right? Those are my priorities. That means I have to read a lot. It's not going to be easy, it's hard. When you make the right moves, it means you're going to make hard living. It's not going to be easy. Damn, it means you have to spend a lot of time staying awake and reading. You know, maths, you've got to work those. So many times you're going to fail, but you're going to rise up and say, I'm going to rise up and I'm going to do it again and again and again and again until I pass. Some people are weak when you fail once and say, come on now, I'm going to leave this. No. If you fail, tell yourself you're going to do it again and again and again until you pass. So find someone, share with someone what you want to do with your life and what you need to achieve that. How is that? And you can do that as you eat. Very good. Any questions from the music? Any questions from the music? No questions. That's good. So what we're going to do is we'll go for a break and then we have our lunch. But before that, I don't know, sister, whether we can have a prayer together for lunch before, or we can find some time later. I don't know. Yeah.
There's a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his own.
You know, the capital city is not China. We have phones to keep in touch, yeah? And I'll be coming back as much as possible. If we love one another, it will work out.
My baby, I love you so much.
Sweet girl from Africa, sing along for you. Let me take you to the moon and the sun, my queen.
I am Anjali, a high school student. It's Lambert, my boyfriend. He has just obtained his high school diploma and is soon heading to the capital for his graduate studies at the agronomy faculty. What breaks my heart is the idea of him being away. We've been together for a very short time, and even though we really love one another, I am afraid that our young love will not survive the test of our separation. It is 1 year, 6 months, and 22 days since we last saw each other. I am in my final year now. We call each other less and less, and we almost never exchange letters. I am increasingly finding it difficult to resist the advances of Bernard, my class prefect, who is deeply in love with me.
What am I doing wrong?
Doing wrong.
Yes, baby, I love you so.
Love you so.
Baby, tell me what it is I can do to make things right. What am I doing wrong? Cause baby, I love you so.
Love you so.
Baby, tell me what to do so I can make everything right.
Dear Angela, today is a great day for me. Besides blowing my 22nd candle, I'm starting my internship at my dream company. I had to submit my application 3 times. As far as I'm concerned, this is the best birthday gift ever. Rejoice with me. Don't take my silence to mean that I've forgotten you. I love you, and I always think of you.
Huh, Lambert. Come in, please. Do you know my daughter Lambert?
Yes, she often comes to see you.
Indeed. But do you know that she admires you very much? That she only speaks of you?
No, no, sir.
In fact, she comes here more because of you than me. According to me, you are a very serious young man and very knowledgeable. During the short time you've been here, I can say that you have shown a lot of quality. If I have a son-in-law like you, I think that I can retire quietly because I know that my company will be in good hands. You are young and serious, and a brilliant career awaits you. If you want, you can start your career in this office after your internship.
And you are thinking. But what are you thinking about, Lambert? All you have to do now is to go to your boss and say yes.
I knew that I'll find you here.
Lambert kept his promise. He resisted tempting proposals from his boss. He resisted pressure from his friend. He found his love, Angela. He found a good job. Lambert and Angela got married.
My brother, you must do everything to avoid it, my sister.